silver bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding dong, ding dong, that is their song, with joyful ring, all caroling. One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound, o'er hill and dale, telling the tale. Gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. On they pound, on without end, their joyful tone to every home. Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding dong, ding dong, that is their song, with joyful ring, all caroling. One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound, o'er hill and dale, telling their tale. Gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Dawn on they send, on without end, their joyful tone to every home.
Dawn on they send, on without end, their joyful tone to every home.
Must bow all things on earth with one accord. Those in heaven shall call you Lord.
Come, O Lord, and bring your light.
us while we dwell below. From all assaults of our dread foe.
Come, O Lord, and bring your light, O radiant star, heart's delight. O God, with us Emmanuel, with your love the dark dispel. To God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit, three in one, praise, honor, might, and glory be, from age to age eternally. Come, O Lord, and bring your light, O radiant star, heart's delight. O God, with us Emmanuel, with your love the dark dispel.
Gaudete Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete. Gaudete, gaudete Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Tempus adas gratiae, o quod optabamus, Carmina Laetitiae devotere damus.
Gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Homo factus est natura mirande, mundus renovatus est a Christo regnat.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
All right, Chiefs play at 2:00 today, so good luck to the Chiefs. I just see one brown sweatshirt here. I won't tell you where he's seated so he can have a peaceful mass. If we win, we will be playing Buffalo in Kansas City. My brother is not reffing the Chiefs game today. He's reffing the Saints game tonight. So he is number 68 if you watch it. All right, if you're wanting to get a COVID vaccine, you need to sign up. And if you don't know where to sign up, just Google Cass County COVID, and there's a vaccine info button. Just click that, and you can sign up for your COVID vaccine. If you're a veteran, you can get one now at the veterans downtown. So we already have some veterans that have gotten their vaccine. So if you would like to, and if you are a veteran, just look into that. All right, we are taking advanced signups for our Ash Wednesday service. We will have 8 a.m. Mass in English and 7 p.m. bilingual. And that is on February 17th. So sign up if you want to guarantee your space in the church. We can only have so many people in the church, and all other extras will be in the gym watching on live stream. But if you can't get into the church, the gym will also offer ashes, and you don't have to stay for Mass if you don't want to for the live stream. We cannot put ashes on the forehead. Last I heard from the diocese, which I really haven't heard officially, is they're saying, like they do in Europe, they just sprinkle them on the crown of your head. So, whatever. All right. Today we have a special collection for Catholic Home Missions. Tomorrow, the parish office will be closed in observance of Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Blood drive will be Tuesday, January 19th from 1:30 to 6. See the bulletin for details on scheduling your appointment. If you would like to take a poinsettia home today after Mass, you may take one home if you would like. Remember, if you sing at Mass, you must wear your mask. Remember, the worship aids are found on our parish website. If you have not received your calendar in English or Spanish, you may pick one up after Mass. If the ushers don't know where they're at, they're over in that alcove. All right, we're also testing new platforms for our This Week at St. Sabina emails. So if you did not receive an email in the last week or two, either we don't have your email address or it's going to your junk folder. So if it is in your junk folder, you just need to right click and mark it as not junk, okay? Unless you think it's junk, whatever. All right, but it's usually pretty good. I like it. All right, any birthdays? Over here, yeah, Emmy, I already told her happy birthday. When is your birthday? Friday. Happy birthday, early. You get more beautiful every year. She didn't even hear it. Any other? All right, when's your birthday? Friday, how old? 24? Oh my God, I'm getting older. You look young. Happy birthday. Usually I don't ask after 21. Is that it? Do you still get carded? I got carded till I was 35, so once you're 40, you'll appreciate that. Any anniversaries? All right, let's wish everybody at home happy birthdays and happy anniversaries. And go Chiefs.
We will be singing Come and Journey with the Savior for the opening.
Come and journey with the Savior who has called us from our birth, who has washed us in the waters, and who loved us on the earth. Come and journey with the Savior who has come. We are all God's sons and daughters. In the Spirit we are one. In the Spirit.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
With your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, in today's readings, we focus on being attuned to hearing God's call and responding with openness and trust. For the times we have failed to respond to his call in our own lives, we ask for mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Messiah, the anointed one of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the true teacher who shows the way to everlasting life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
To God in the highest, and on earth.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our time. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. slaughtered goats or lambs. Though my heart you gave me ears to hear you, then I said, here I am.
Here I am, Lord.
Here
I am. I come to do your will. You wrote it in the scrolls of law.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 p.m. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
About 15 or 20 years ago, I decided with my parents and my little brother to plan a trip to Europe. And so I had to plan a trip where we flew to Rome, and then went from Rome to Florence, Florence to Venice, Venice to Nice, Nice to Paris, and Paris to London. And my parents went a week early, and I stayed a week late. And then I also had to get Eurail passes for everybody. So it was a lot of planning and a lot of work and a lot of stress, because I'd never planned like a big trip like that before. And so I got everything booked, and we got over there. You know, there was, you know, Mom and Dad enjoyed their time in London. They figured out one night that the faucets turned the wrong direction, and Mom about flooded the house. But everything was working out good. So once I got there and we met in Rome, then my little brother decided to start taking control. And so he was trying to tell us everything we needed to do, and I'm, you know, trying to keep us like on task so that we figure out where the train station is for the next town, the hotels that we're staying in that I had booked. And so my brother and I kind of argued our way through Europe. And it wasn't until about halfway through the trip, we were having dinner in this Italian restaurant. And as customary in Italy, you know, after you have dinner, you have a digestivo. You know, a little grappa, as they call it. You know, like a homemade moonshine type drink that's pretty strong. So after two of those, all of the stress was just gone. And we're all just laughing and having the best time. And my dad said to us as he was laughing, he said, "You know, I'm just so proud. I raised all of you kids to be leaders." And I thought, what? I'd never put that together. But that's kind of why we argue a lot, because we're all wanting to lead. We're all wanting to control. And so I started thinking about what makes a good leader. So in the gospel today, we hear Jesus asking, telling, inviting his followers, "Come and you will see. Come and follow me." And they did. And their life changed forever from that point on. And so they followed Jesus for 3 years. You can call it disciple internship. And it wasn't until after 3 years of intense teaching and following were they able to become leaders. Peter, "Upon this rock, I will build my church." So Jesus was leading them to do what they did. But they had to follow and learn in order to be good leaders in the church. To be a good leader now, since we're not Jesus, we have to follow as we're getting educated in order to become leaders. But when we become leaders, we still need to maintain at some points in our life, we also have to follow. So I look at example of businesses. You know, there's people in this parish that own their own business. They're their own boss. I'm a pastor. I lead the staff. But to be a good leader, in order to maintain and make the most money that you can make and sell the most that you want, you have to know what's happening down below. So you have to listen to those who are working for you. So you have to find that balance. Because if you lose that balance, you become a controller. And you become a micromanager. And you're going to hurt your own business. And it's the same way in the church. If I get my way all the time, and I try to micromanage everybody, then we're not going to have the best liturgy. Things are not going to go as well as they could. And so we meet, and you know, I have people in our staff that does certain things, and they keep me accountable. You know, the most recent one was, you know, the sacrament for the children's, sacrament of penance, first reconciliation for the children. You know, I was wanting to cancel it because of COVID. But I lost. So we're having it. So I lose a lot, and that's okay. Because I have to look at the reasons why I'm wanting to do this and balance that to see, okay, is this better for me or is this better for everybody? And a lot of times, we don't necessarily think what's best for everybody. You know, with my parents traveling through Europe, you know, at some times, I was thinking about what was best. Sometimes my little brother was thinking about what was best. You know, one thing that I did over there is I always followed behind my mom and dad. Because it was their first trip to Europe, and they were not used to pickpocketers. So I always walked a few steps behind to make sure nobody's hands went into mom's constantly open purse as she was walking along. But yet, you know, I was trying to be culturally traveled because I had traveled to Europe a lot, and, you know, dinner time over there was at 8:30, 9 o'clock, 9:30, very, very late. Based on our culture. Mom and Dad wanted dinner at 5:30, which was late for them. Now we order them dinner at 4:30. But so I was telling them, you need to wait. We need to do what's in the culture. I wasn't thinking about what was best for them. I was thinking, you know, I don't want the locals to make fun of us. So we have to be honest with ourselves. And we have to remember, you know, we don't have everything. We are not Christ. And we need to follow Christ constantly. We need to always be looking for him. And he's always inviting us to continue to change our life and follow him. In order to be a good Catholic and to lead other people to God, we can't do that if we're not a follower. So think about your average everyday life. Do we open ourselves up to allowing and listening God to enter into our life? Do we open ourselves up even in the normal daily activities of our own jobs, our own families? Is there just one person that tells everybody what to do? I was lucky. In my family, there were 11 people that all were telling everybody what to do. But we always moved forward because eventually we would find a solution. So we do that in our faith. We do that in our politics. We do that in our daily life. Being a follower of Christ means having open ears, open hearts, and open minds, and allowing that Spirit to work through us versus us trying to control the Spirit to work how we want it to work. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess in one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the limitless compassion of our God and his care for all of creation, let us bring our needs before him.
For the church, that we may introduce others to Christ through virtuous lives, loving deeds, and truthful words, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing of our nation, that God will heal the divisions in our country, guide all elected officials in fulfilling their duties, and help them to work selflessly for the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christian unity, that we who are the temple of God and the body of Christ may grow in our understanding of each other and cooperate in announcing the good news through visible acts of love for one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our candidates and catechumens, and for all who are discerning their life's calling, that they, like Samuel, may say, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening," and offer their gifts and talents for the glory of God and the service of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering, that God will heal the sick, guide those seeking employment, protect the homeless, and comfort the grieving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, that we may quiet our hearts and minds so that we may perceive God's presence and invitations through the words of Scripture and our daily experiences, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whom God has called to eternal life, especially Marv Henrich, may they rejoice to remain forever with the teacher they followed on earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you call us by name and desire to bring us to the fullness of life. Hear our prayers that with ears attuned to your voice, we might listen for your call and answer, "Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will." And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Cry, all who dwell in darkness.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your children. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The food that will pass away, set your hearts on.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Let us sing, God Has Chosen Me.